You've got 3 cycles, Peter. Not 4, not 5. 3. Contact me when you've got the units.
And if we don't?
The device we installed will deactivate your ship, and you will all go to prison.
Gotcha. We won't let you down.
You said you could get us out of this.
I did. 7,000 units is a small price.
7,000 units?
That is a tremendous sum.
Where are we gonna get that kind of money? In 3 cycles?
By robbing a freaking bank, apparently.
Okay! So we got fined. We have a Nova tracking thing on our ship that's gonna shut down our engines if we don't pay that fine in 3 cycles. At least we're not on a prisoner transport.
Not yet.
Come on, guys. You're Drax the Destroyer, man. You killed Thanos.
Allegedly.
Are you gonna let a little fine slow you down? And Gamora, you're practically an MI6 agent, but way hotter and cooler. There's nothing you can't do.
Here it comes.
Rocky, you're an actual genius and the scrappiest dude I know. How many prisons did you break out of?
7.
I am Groot.
You are Groot. Guys, we're supposed to be a team. All we need to do is figure out how broke we are and come up with a plan. So check your quarters. Check between the sofa cushions. Check under the crafting bench. If you find any spare units lying around, grab them. I'll do the same in my quarters.
All right.
This is why you don't sleep with cops, Quill. They put bombs on my ship.
My ship.
I am watching you, Rodent.
What's that supposed to mean?
It is common knowledge that rodents hoard. Nuts, stolen technology, units.
Okay, first off, I ain't a hoarder, nor a rodent.
I know you have a stash hidden aboard this ship. Fetch it, now.
There ain't nothing to fetch. Groot blew our stash on Contraxia, and the rest I gave to Quill and Gamora for the Dash Quarantine Zone access code.
A likely story.
Why don't you go bother someone else?
I intend to.
What do you want, Quill? If you're looking for units, check your own room.
Open this door! I know you are in there, sentient tree! Do not think that I do not know what you are up to. Your rodent co-conspirator has clearly stashed his illicit units in there.
I am Groot.
I am watching you, tree. Any units I uncover will go directly to you, but I am unsure the others will do the same.
So, you're taking the whole find the units thing pretty seriously.
It is a serious matter.
Yeah, I totally get it. We're all afraid of going back to prison.
I am not afraid of going back to prison.
Oh, good. Because I'm not either, mostly.
In the kiln, I was surrounded by criminals, murderers, and thieves. They taught me a harsh lesson. Assassins and bounty hunters cannot be trusted.
Okay. Wow. Don't you think maybe you're calling the kettle black?
I have not mentioned kitchenware.
It's an Earth thing. What I mean is, you're a convicted mass murderer. I used to be a pirate. We're not exactly upstanding citizens.
You and I honor our word. I cannot say the same for the others.
You could be wrong, Drax. You won't know until you give them a chance.
We will see.
Groot? You okay in there? Think you could open the door for a minute? Is that my toothbrush? Great. Now I need a new toothbrush. Hey, Gamora.
You're supposed to knock.
What are you doing? You're supposed to be looking for money.
I did.
And?
I don't have any.
Also, what's with the dolls?
Do Do you value your life?
Is that a trick question? Okay, yes, mostly I value my life.
Good. Then pretend like you saw nothing and get out.
See you in the lounge?
Out.
Got it. Why does this thing look so sinister?
Hey, who said you could touch that? I don't go into your room and touch your stuff, Quill.
What? You hacked my visor and added a scoreboard to it while I was sleeping.
That was different. I improved it. Also, did anyone tell you that you snore? I thought Drax was bad, but wow. Quill, you should really get that checked. You sound like a Torg.
I don't snore that loud.
Yeah, okay.
So what is this thing anyway? It kind of looks like a metal face hugger.
That is clearly a spinal control unit.
Yes, right, of course, a spinal control thingy.
Back on Half-World, Kree scientists use these to keep us super soldiers in line. They'd press a big, fun red button and zap! Instant obedience.
Holy crap. Rocket. How many of you super soldiers were there on Half-World?
When the Kree started, 100, maybe. By the time I escaped, just me and Lila. She was the first one not to die from the control unit.
And Lila is also a...
What? A raccoon?
Or not. A raccoon?
You gotta understand. She was afraid of them, and the control unit made sure we stayed in line. That I stayed in line.
Oh, that sounds awful. I can't imagine.
So, I did what I do best. I found a way to overload the control unit. When the Blueskins let us out of our cage, kaboom! I blew a hole into the side of the lab. What we didn't know... What I... didn't know was that the lab was protected by sentry bots. We got to the security fence and Lila covered me while I hacked the modulator frequency, and as soon as it opened, she pushed me through the door. I heard her die, Quill.
Rocket.
Doesn't matter now. Past is the past, right? And that thing is just a reminder.
What exactly did the Kree do to you?
They ripped me apart and rebuilt me over and over and over again until I became this half-finished thing they could mold and shape and control.
Oh, Rocket, I had no idea. I mean, I knew the Kree Empire was desperate, but...
Do you know what it's like to lose all control of your body? To be in constant pain, trapped inside yourself, unable to stop the horrible things you're doing? That control unit made sure I did what I was supposed to do. Oh yeah, whether I wanted to or not. A neat, furry little machine of death. Didn't take long to figure out I was better off not fighting it.
Okay, then let's shoot this thing out the airlock. Have a little middle finger salute ceremony to the bastards who built it.
I don't think I'm ready to let go of that part of me yet. Maybe one day.
Are you 100% sure you want to keep it? What if it...
controls me? I decided a long time ago, Quill, that I would never let anyone control me again. As far as I'm concerned, this is just another useful piece of junk and a few bad memories.
Sorry you had to go through all that, Rocket. For real. Hey, Bluebird, you copy? I know you think I sold you out, and... Gamora, I was just...
Who are you talking to? What's a Bluebird?
It, was Yondu's call sign. He was Bluebird and I was the kid.
Let me get this straight. Yondu Udonta, leader of the Ravager space virus, scourge of the Sirius system and all-around scoundrel, used Bluebird as his call sign?
Even had it embroidered on the back of his jacket.
Amazing.
It was amazing. Pretty much from the day we met.
How did you two meet? Terrans and Centaurians aren't exactly neighbors.
We met on Chitauri Prime, about 3 years into my sentence.
Wait, Yondu was a prisoner of war? I thought the Ravagers were neutral.
They were, and they also weren't. The Ravagers had a simple code: steal from everyone. Yondu said it made them neutral.
But they weren't. I specifically remember several Chitauri transports being hit when I was still... you know.
They hit just as many resistance ships, until a Chitauri cruiser uncloaked in front of them during a raid and...
Yondu ended up on Chitauri Prime, with you.
Mm-hmm. After we broke out, he could have left me on some space station or dropped me off at the nearest Nova Corps base, but he didn't. Instead, he invited me to join the Ravagers.
You were with them a long time. Must have enjoyed it.
I did. Being a Ravager was the first time I felt like I really belonged, if that makes any sense.
I felt the same way when I joined Richard Ryder and the Resistance. Like I was finally in control of who I wanted to be.
Yes, exactly. Those first few years, it was like I had joined this really big, really dysfunctional family, which, now that I'm hearing it, would make Yondu my...
space dad?
Could have been worse. Yondu and I were cellmates. First thing he said when they put him in my cell was, "Boy, don't be going and getting attached, because I'm just here for the food." And the food was pretty terrible, so...
Yeah, that sounds like Yondu.
I had cellmates before, and none of them lasted long. The Chitauri have these gladiatorial games, and...
You got used to people dying.
Not sure about that, but I didn't expect anyone to last long. I also didn't have my translation implant back then, so I might as well have been alone. But Yondu, he actually spoke English. Said he'd offered to translate in exchange for extra rations.
So even in the snake-infested hellhole, ever the schemer.
It's something we had in common. I'd been scheming for a way to escape since the day they took me. I just needed someone like Yondu to make it seem possible.
How did you escape?
Let's just say it was equal parts simple, complicated, and kind of embarrassing. But it ended with the two of us delivering a transport full of stolen supplies straight into the hands of the Resistance.
For a bucket-load of units, too, I bet.
Anyway, once we did, there was no going back. I was a Ravager. Well, if you don't mind, I think I'd like to be alone for a bit.
Oh, yeah, sure. I'll see you around.
Well, well, well. Let's see if we can find some stray units in here. Really?
units?
We appear to be 6,963 units short. If we intend to keep our ship, Peter Quill...
I know. We clearly need a plan.
And reconsider my initial proposal.
Oh, no, not Fin Fang Foom again.
Yes, we should go after Fin Fang Foom.
Drax, there are easier ways to get paid. Like, what about selling Gamora's crap?
What?
Oh, come on. You've been hoarding them stupid knickknacks ever since you first joined us. I mean, Don't tell me they ain't worth nothing.
Quarantine zone was always
holding out on
my figurines are not knickknacks.
Team's in trouble. Then you can't be bothered to make no sacrifice.
Set course for the Mockingstar
system. I will sacrifice your head
and take us to the
guys. I think we should hear out Groot for once.
I am Groot.
He says we should combine both ideas.
Sell Gamora's trinkets to Fin Fang Foom. It is brilliant.
Yeah, you know, the only problem with your plan is that Lady Hellbender only buys monsters, and you are not a monster. He's not. He's the sweetest, most...
I am Groot.
No, you don't. This ain't something you can pretend.
I am Groot.
Oh, yeah? You want monster? I'll show you monster!
Whoa, guys!
Groot, are you really offering to...
No, no, he is not offering that, okay?
It could work.
Sell Groot? I guess we could bust him out after.
Absurd. Lady Hellbender seeks the monster within. The small, ugly one is clearly the correct choice. He is cruel, sadistic, and his soul is filthy and filled with rage. Monster Queen would pay a great sum for such a creature.
Really? How great?
How are you okay with this?
Because I know what I am, and I know what he ain't.
I am Groot.
I vote we sell Groot. I honestly think Lady Hellbender will go for it.
Yeah, well, I vote for not Groot.
I also vote for the creepy little beast.
2 votes each. Peter?
Well, I think Groot's more convincing, in the traditional monster sense. Groot, buddy, first of all, thank you. And second of all, I want you to know we're gonna bust you out of there right after, okay?
I am Groot.
All right, let's do this. Let's go sell a monster.
We're not seriously flying into that.
They say the weather patterns of Sekhnarf 9 are tied to the temperament of its ruler.
That's not how women work.
Or weather. Anyways, I'm sure it looks worse than it is. Piece of cake.
You can't be serious.
What? This way we can scope things out before we finish the transaction.
We're like 100 clicks from her base.
You know how much I like scoping. Nope.